Okay, so Pranav, let's record your interview experience in a different institute, IIT Indore and IISc Bangalore. So before yes, I record, Pranav, all I know is you're from electronics background. I want yes, to know, Pranav, aapne graduation kab kiya, from which college you yes, graduated and which area, which state? And then what is your GATE score, what is your CGPA and what is your category?
Yes, sir. So I am doing currently BTech in Vishwakarma Institute of Technology, Pune.
Okay.
I'm in fourth year, last semester. Mm-hmm. So I appeared in this GATE 2021 and my All India rank is 289. Okay. And GATE score is 746 in general category.
Okay.
So, and my CGPA is 9.69 currently till seventh semester.
Okay. ग्रेट सो इस क्रेडेंशियल के बेस पे प्रणव आपको कहां कहां से कॉल्स आया है टोटल अभी तक
इन कोप राउंड
नहीं नहीं अभी तक मतलब इंटरव्यू कॉल या वैसे जो भी कॉल आया है कोप राउंड पे मैं अभी बाद में आता हूं पहले मेरे को ये बताओ कि कॉल्स कहां कहां से आया था
यस सो फ्रॉम आईआईएससी बेंगलोर आई गॉट फॉर आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस एमटेक इट वाज माय फर्स्ट प्रेफरेंस सो आई डायरेक्टली गॉट दैट Then electronic system engineering MS MTech research program computational data science. Mm-hmm. Then in IIT Madras Texas Instruments electrical engineering. then computer science and as well as engineering design.
Mm-hmm.
In IIT Indore in VLSI, mm-hmm. and I didn't feel much forms in lower IIT, so okay. I didn't appear for it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so wherever I appeared, I got the interview call. In Delhi, I think they have not yet declared for the other branches. Only they declared for VLSI MS, mm-hmm. where they mailed me that my score is not above their cutoff.
Mm-hmm.
So,
अच्छा प्रणव एक ने अपने Texas Instrumentation का नाम लिया. That is supposed to be very good, ना?
Yes, yes, yes.
वो कहाँ पे है?
Yes, so IIT Madras, they have this program in electrical engineering in integrated circuits.
Okay.
Which is collaborated with Texas Instruments.
So the placement is given by Texas Instrumentation?
Yeah, yeah. So basically it is sponsored by Texas Instruments. Okay. And as I remember, even the sponsorship amount is different. Like MHRD gives 12,400 or 13,400 depending mm-hmm. on course.
Mm-hmm.
But here it's around 22,000 or something.
Okay, monthly.
Yeah, and also you get a chance to do internship in Texas Instruments, and depending mm-hmm. on your performance, they might also give you offer for job.
Mm-hmm. And so you tried for that also?
Yes, yes, I tried okay. for that.
Okay, okay. So now I'm coming to your experience, Pranav. Of before I come to that, tell me, aapka COP round one ka mein kuch reflect hua hai abhi tak?
Yes, yes, sir. IIT Indore, VLSI MTech. So I have only got one offer till now.
ओके okay. आपने उसको रिटेन पे डाला है या फ्रीज किया है
नहीं रिटेन पे डाला
है रिटेन पे डाल दिया ठीक है चलो अभी आज सेकंड राउंड है 4th जून को COAP yes. का मे बी सम मोर रिजल्ट्स विल बी रिफ्लेक्टेड प्रणव दैट इज कंप्यूटेशनल एंड डेटा साइंस सो टेल मी अबाउट दैट दैट वाज एमटेक ओनली
या एमटेक रिसर्च
ओके
सो दिस वाज ऑन द सेम डे इन आईआईएससी द थिंग वाज हियर जनरली व्हाट आई हैव सीन like people tell that even if you are from another background, you can apply for this program. And it's okay if you don't know because you are from another background. But this was not what they were expecting. Even if you are from electronics or instrumentation, you must know the fundamentals and more than a beginner level because it's a research program and they the competition is very high. They only take very few people. So when I went there, they asked me about my project. I told them my project. Then they didn't question much about the project, but they okay. They said, can we ask you about PCA? So back 2 years, somewhere I read about PCA, but in current syllabus or in even electronics, I didn't encounter this much. So I told them, I don't know about this, but whatever I know, I told them the definition of principal component analysis and all. And then he was like, okay, then can we ask you on linear algebra? And they proceeded. Here also, he asked one question.
Mm-hmm.
Like if the A, he told me, let's say there is a matrix A with size m cross n.
Mm-hmm.
And I calculate A transpose. Then you tell me what will be the rank of A transpose.
Mm-hmm.
So this is actually the property where the rank of A transpose and rank of A has mm-hmm. to be the, has to be not, it is same always.
Mm-hmm.
So I didn't know this property. So either they were expecting me to know this property, or they were expecting me to derive this property in front of them while solving. So I tried hard for a while, but I didn't get any answer, like what to say. And they tried to push me, but they didn't give much hints and all. And also the start was not very good. I mean, when I said I don't know PCA, then it reflected that I'm not much well versed in this computer science related field. So they asked me, okay, then linear regression and all. So here, so I told them very properly what linear regression is. So they asked me again the mean square error. And here the thing is, there are two ways to calculate mean square error. One, we can calculate vertical error or horizontal, which we also call as y on x error or x on y error. So I knew this concept. He asked me what is this and that. So I told him whether the you will get the different equation. Then also answered yes, we will get the different equation. Now here is what I think that ISC people always try to do is, so if this is different, and as a research student, so whenever you're doing project, so what will you select, on what basis? These are two equations you can select. So he asked me which one will you select, and I didn't know. Like, I mean, I had never worked on this project, and so I answered that I will select both, and I will calculate the accuracy at the end, and I will compare which model gives me more accuracy. On that, he said it's okay. He laughed and he said it's okay, but as a design student, like as the research student, it is not always possible to check every possibilities, every permutation and combination. So you must have some mathematical background when you select some certain things and you don't select some other aspects. So yeah, that is it. It got over. But again, I mean, they are looking for very short, less amount of people. So I don't think my interview was that smooth. So I think I will not get in this.
Okay. Pranav, tell me, like computational and data science, may student think that knowledge of coding or algorithm will be required? Is it true or only mathematics will do?
Well, the mathematics, I think mathematics will do what they asked me about mathematics. And even the PCA is not related to coding directly. So it's about eigenvalues and dimensional reduction and all. So they were not expecting you much coding. But yeah, there was a written test as a screening test before the interview, where they asked, there were around 8 to 10 MCQ questions based on the simple engineering mathematics. So the probability was quite difficult. I mean, it was more practical oriented. So the questions were not straightforward. They gave some real scenario from which you have to calculate some probability. And another questions were some calculus, linear algebra here and there. So simple questions. And also there were two MCQs where I think you must know the basic coding. So they give some code snippets of two questions, and they asked what should be the output. It was an MCQ type question. So they used the HackerEarth platform to conduct this exam. And also there were two questions of programming. So where one was for 5 marks, it was a kind of easy moderate question where we have to write actual code and run the test cases. And there was one 10-mark question, which I was not able to solve, but it was pretty like above moderate difficult kind of. Yeah, so I think you must have some basic knowledge, at least basic knowledge of programming, and you must know how to code simple code. Well, I don't think that they're expecting you to be expert in that, because I didn't answer that 10 marks question, but still I got selected based on the another engineering mathematics questions and the 5 marks programming question.
So Pranav, tell me one thing, like out of all these interviews which you had, which one is your dream now? Where would you like to join?
Yeah, so currently I'm thinking of IIT Madras in integrated circuits.
Is
In the
Texas Instrumentation, huh?
no. So the Texas, actually they declared the result and I was not selected. First they selected very few people from written test where I got selected. But after the interview, I don't know exactly the number, but they selected very few people. They generally select only 3 to 4 people, I guess. Oh, okay. I didn't got selected, but even it was not like my dream to go over there, because it is good, Texas Instrument and all, but it is more analog related. So it's the VLSI in analog. So
okay.
Right now, as we can compare, you know, analog and digital VLSI. So digital VLSI has got like really good scope right now. It's not that analog don't have any scope. It has, but yeah, so
That is what you would like to join. Great. Yeah. So what are the new interviews in pipeline, Pranav, for you?
IIT Bombay M.Tech RA.
Okay, that is in pipeline. When is the interview? Any idea?
They didn't give me exact date. The range is from 13 to 18.
Okay. So, Pranav, now last question I want to ask you. You had many interviews and many places you applied. What is the learning at the end of the day? When, after all these interviews, what you have learned?
Yeah, so from every interview, I have learned something different. So I will tell the Texas Instruments, they actually took my interview for 5 to 10 minutes. Okay. So they asked me a question. What I felt after the interview, there's a difference between being an engineer and being a mathematician. So what the difference is actually what I see many of the students, we are not good engineers, but we are good mathematicians. We know equation, you give the problem, we know the certain rules, certain constraints, we apply the equations and we solve it. But as an engineer, you must have that different perspective towards problems. When you see the problem, you must understand how the output is going to be. So I'm an electronics engineer. Looking at the circuit, I must able to visualize how the output is actually going to be. I don't need always to use KVL, KCL, and then find out what the exact answer. Obviously, mathematics is the language of science, so you need it. But at least that intuition should be there as an engineer. So there is a difference between an electrician and electronics engineer. There has to be. So that is one thing I learned from the Texas Instrument interview. Because what happened, they asked me a simple question, but you know, I need to calculate certain things what they asked me. When I took my pen, they requested me not to use pen and paper and answer without it. So you know, I answered it correctly, but then they added some more complexity, and again they wanted me to answer without pen and paper. They said, you know, answer with your intuition and all, but then I was unable to answer because I was habituated to solve everything. No pen and paper, solve these what Laplace domain equations and all and get the answer. This is one thing I learned. The another is from the IAS interviews, I learned that when we are learning anything, we must always question like why this, why that. So we must try to look in design perspective. What mostly in BTEC, what we are taught is to analyze. And analysis, right? So they we are given always circuits, and we are expected to calculate voltage in on this nodes and all, or currents in branches. But we never think more in design perspective. Why this resistance? Why this much value? In a circuit in analog, there is everything is designing amplifiers and all. But this is what we don't learn mostly in BTEC at least. So yeah, that was one learning that as an engineer, even if one doesn't have to go in the research field, but this perspective has to be there in the engineer. When you go for M.Tech, again, you are going to something innovate or something. You are doing, after all, some research.
Great. So Pranav, what is the ultimate dream? What do you want at the end of the day?
Sir, see, I don't have like a dream company or something. What my idea is that at the end of the, let's say like in 10 years or down 10 years time, so I must be able to contribute in the whatever field I'm going to do.
Okay.
And that contribution must be kind of worth it. I mean, just for money sake, I don't want to do job in anywhere. So one thing I'm thinking is if I'm able to combine the VLSI and the artificial intelligence and all these things, so I might be able to build some good processors or some kind of stuff. And I have this idea of moving into more biomedical field. So if I build some a device which will help, like there is one lab in ISC which I applied also for. It's working on biomedical engineering, and they are designing electronic devices to deal with cancers and all. So So this is kind of work I would like to do. There's no dream company, but the idea is that I should contribute at the end. I'm also interested, and that is why I'm more research oriented. Like I applied for MS, and I would prefer MS over MTech. So yeah, this is the thing.
Great. चलो प्रणव, ऑल द वेरी बेस्ट फॉर ऑल योर सिलेक्शंस एंड आई विश
Yes.
यू ऑल द बेस्ट फॉर दिस एंड कीप थैंक्स अ लॉट फॉर शेयरिंग योर दिस एक्सपीरियंस एंड कीप शेयरिंग मी योर अदर एक्सपीरियंसेस.